someone might be interested in how I make coils for my projects. So I decided to make a video about it. After all, making such coils is not at all difficult. Of course, you can buy ready-made coils from Platik. This is sold on AliExpress. But first, will you find the right size? Secondly, if your coil gets hot, you will be disappointed with its behavior. For demonstration purposes, I will make coils in different materials and sizes. Cut as many strips of thin film as possible to a width of 1.5 to 2 centimeters. I use food packaging bags. You will need this tape from the bottom and then the top when making an epoxy cylinder. This rod is from construction reinforcement with a diameter of 20 millimeters. Its surface is rough and not round enough. Therefore, it is better to wrap this first with 2-3 layers of thin paper. Otherwise, you will not be able to remove the cylinder after the epoxy has cured. If the rod is perfectly round and smooth, 2-3 layers of thin film or 1 layer of thick film is sufficient. Do not use tape with glue, as this will prevent you from removing the finished cylinder. I fix only the end with a small piece of adhesive tape. This is a dough cylinder made of 6 layers of baking paper. This paper is thin and 6 layers does not provide sufficient strength. From this paper I will wind 12 layers. Cut the right amount of material for the cylinders in advance. All materials and tools must be prepared prior to preparing the epoxy and placed in convenient locations. It is highly advisable to use one piece of paper or fiberglass. Therefore, if you will be using more than one piece of tape, glue them firmly together before winding. I didn't do this and it made it difficult to tension the tape while winding. It is necessary to soak the tape well with epoxy over the entire area and always on both sides. Don't work like me, use rubber gloves when working with epoxy. Duct tape over epoxy is also a bad option. Because after the cylinders have hardened, you will have to wash it with solvent from the glue. Therefore, use polyethylene tape or other non-adhesive tape. Nevertheless, in some places it turned out to be airy. To eliminate this, you need more epoxy and a denser winding and also a dense film winding over the cylinders. However, if you are making coils not for the space station, then this is so critical. Of course, the strongest cylinder is made from fiberglass. I decided to make the sides of the paper cylinder from paper as well.